Hallelujah, in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
Hallelujah, 奉主耶稣圣名，我在这里讲话。
Please join me in a silent prayer.
请大家跟我一起低下头，同心默祷。
Hallelujah, Amen.
Hallelujah, Amen.
I just want to thank God for giving me this opportunity.
我非常的感谢神给我今天这样的机会。
I'm greatly honored to be able to testify about the love and grace of God today.
我很荣幸今天能够在这里见证神给我的爱跟他的大能。
I was born in Afghanistan.
我在阿富汗出生。
And I was born in a Muslim family.
我是出生在一个穆斯林的家庭。
I have two sisters and a brother.
我有两个姐妹跟一个弟弟。
And when I was a little girl in Afghanistan, I remember my life was quite beautiful.
我想起来，我以前小时候在阿富汗的时候，我的生活其实是很美好的。
Because I had my parents, I had my siblings, my grandmother, everyone with us.
因为那时候家里有很多人很热闹，有我的妈妈，有我的爸爸，还有我的祖父母，还有弟兄姐妹。
And those are very beautiful moments of my life.
那些是我人生里面很美丽的部分。
And we had a good life because at that time Afghanistan was at peace.
那个时候生活很美好，因为阿富汗那时候还很平安。
But when I was about 9 or 10 years old, the Russians invaded our country.
但是在我九岁到十岁的时候，那时候，苏联在攻打我们的国家。
And suddenly, there was no more peace at my home.
在我的家里，突然之间就失去了和平。
Although financially we were blessed, but there was no peace.
虽然在经济上我们家里还不错，但是我们家里已经失去了平安。
Because the Russians, they put many people in the prison.
因为那时候，俄国的人，他们把很多人都下到监牢里面。
So my mother was very afraid that my father would be the next one.
那时候我妈妈每天都担心着我爸爸也会被抓到监牢里面。
So there was, I could feel that there's so much restlessness at home.
那时候可以感受到家里的那种压力。
So finally, my mom and my father, they decided to leave Afghanistan and go to migrate to India.
最后呢，我父母决定了要离开阿富汗，去到印度。
Because my mother was always also afraid for our safety.
因为那个时候我妈妈也担心在飞机上的危险。
Because a lot of people were killed when they go to school on their way.
那个时候很多人在那边，
When the students, when they go to school, sometimes they might have a trouble.
在那时候，学生在那边求学也会遇到问题，也担心我们在那里会遇到问题。
So finally, we left everything, and my parents sold the house, and we moved to India.
那时候我们就把房子也卖了，全家一起搬到印度去。
And my father left his business also.
我父亲也把他的生意结束了。
So when we came to India, it was a brand new country to us.
我们到印度的时候，那个是一个完全陌生的国家。
And in India, we don't know the in Hindi language, we don't know English.
我们不会讲当地的语言，我们的英文也不好。
It was very hard for my parents and for us to settle down.
所以那时候对于我的父母来讲，还有对于我们来讲，在那边安家非常的困难。
And my father, he had brought some money with him, so he started a business. With a partner.
我爸爸当时身上带了些钱，所以在这里那里找了一个人一起开启了生意。
And in the beginning, everything was getting normal because we joined school.
那时候一开始好像事情开始生活开始变得比较有秩序了，我们也开始上学。
And we learned Hindi and English.
我们学会了印度文，也学了英文。
But my father's partner deceived my father, and my father lost all his money.
然而，跟我父亲合作生意的那个人骗了我爸爸所有的钱。
That's the time when again we felt so much, we have no more peace left.
那时候，我们又一次的感觉到了身边缺少了平安。
We became very poor.
我们变得很贫穷。
And we moved to a very small apartment.
我们搬到一个很小很小的公寓。
And my mom and my father always fight over financial problems.
我的爸爸妈妈常常就为了家里钱的问题而吵架。
So in that apartment that we moved, the roof was always leaking.
那时候我们住的公寓，天花板也常常漏水。
And we all jumbled up in one room. We would sleep all in one room.
所以我们被迫要全家人挤在一个房间里面去睡觉。
And by the middle, because we applied to the United Nations.
那时候我们有申请移民到
United Nations Organization for help.
我们申请联合国的援助。
So the United Nations would give us some money every month for our rent.
所以每个月我们从联合国的援助组织那边得到一些钱来到付我们的房租。
And the money was very little because by the middle of the month we have no more food and we have no money to take a bus.
但是那个钱也少得可怜，我们花完了租金以后，到月中的时候，我们就没有钱再去买吃的，也没有钱去坐车。
And our neighbors downstairs, they would cook food, and we would smell the food as children, and we would cry because we want to eat it, but we have no food.
我们的楼下邻居煮饭的时候，那个饭香飘下来的时候，我们就会觉得很难过，开始哭起来，因为我们没有食物可以吃。
So finally, my father, he decided to leave us and go back to Afghanistan to sell his property and come back.
所以我的父亲最后要决定一个人回到阿富汗去，把他剩下的一些产物想要变卖，这样子我们就有生活费了。
So my father left.
这样子我爸爸离开了我们。
And my mother was left with four children.
那我妈妈一个人就带着四个孩子生活。
And no hope and no peace and lot too much of poverty.
我们那时候生活贫穷，没有指望。
And my father never returned back.
然而我的父亲再也没有回来过。
My father completely disappeared.
他完全消失在我们的生活当中。
And my mother and we all thought that maybe my father is killed.
那时候我妈妈跟我们想说可能我爸爸已经遭害了。
But my mother never gave up.
然而我妈妈没有放弃。
My mother had a very strong faith in God.
我妈妈对神有一个很执着的信仰。
She always prayed.
她常常祷告。
And we always, and I always pray with her.
我也常常跟着她祷告。
And we always hope that God will send us some help.
我们常常祈求说神会给我们带来一个帮手。
And because I learned Hindi and English.
因为我学会了印度文跟英文。
So I was able to volunteer in United Nations organization.
所以那时候我在联合国的援助组织里面去当义工。
And the lady who, with whom I volunteered, she really liked me.
而那个组织里面的一个一个女士呢，她非常欣赏我。
I would take the Afghani immigrants to the hospital and translate.
我帮助那些从阿富汗来的人到医院去求医，帮他们去做翻译。
And I would do other translations whenever there was needed.
我也为其他有需要的人去做翻译。
So this lady knew that our condition is very bad and we are very poor.
这位女士知道我们家庭很困境。
She recommended us to apply to different countries for immigration.
所以她建议我们呢，移民到其他的国家去。
So we applied to United States and Australia and everywhere.
我们发了很多的移民申请，包括美国跟澳洲。
Every country rejected us.
但是每一个国家都拒绝了我们的申请。
And my mother, but she didn't give up.
然而我的妈妈还是没有放弃。
Finally, we applied to Canada.
最后我们申请来到加拿大。
And miraculously, Canada accepted us.
非常奇妙的，我们的申请真的得到了接受。
They called us for an interview.
然后我们被叫去面试了。
And during the interview, the lady who interviewed us, she was a Christian.
那个跟我们面试的女士呢，是一个基督徒。
Because when we were telling her our story of our heartache, we could see tears in her eyes.
当我们告知我们的生活状况、我们的背景的时候，我可以看到她眼中的泪光。
And we told her that we believe in God and God will help us.
我们也告诉她说，我们相信神会帮助我们。
And the lady said that she's a Christian and she believes in God also.
那这位女士告诉我们说，她也是一个基督徒，她也信靠神。
And she said, "This Christmas, I promise you, I'm gonna send your family to Canada."
她说，这个圣诞节的时候，我答应你，你们的家人一定可以来到加拿大。
And we saw so much love in her eyes.
我们从她的眼中看到很多的爱。
And indeed, that Christmas, on 24th of December, we came to Canada.
真的，就在那一个，那一年的十二月二十四号，我们全家来到加拿大了。
That was the first impression of me of Christians. I realized that Christians are very loving people.
那是我对基督徒的第一个印象，就是他们都是很充满爱心的人。
So when I came to Canada, we came at that time. For 2 years, the government of Canada supported us.
我们来到加拿大的头两年都是政府资助我们的生活。
And he even gave us social insurance card and helped us find job and go to school.
我们得到了SIM card， 我们也可以上学。
And my mother would tell us that the people here they are so loving and they are so kind.
我妈妈常常挂在嘴边，就是说这里的人真好。
And she said although we are not Christian, but they still love us.
她说虽然我们不是基督徒，但是他们仍然爱我们。
After that, when we moved to Canada in my early teens.
我来到加拿大的时候，我正是十几岁的年纪。
I had many questions with regard to my faith.
对于我的信仰，我有很多的问题。
Because I was born in a Muslim religion.
因为我是在一个回教的环境里面出生长大的。
And Islam is a religion that they believe in the Old Testament.
回教徒呢，他们相信圣经里面旧约的部分。
But I would always ask my mom about why would a man in Islam can have 5 wives?
我常常就问我妈妈这个问题，为什么我们穆斯林的男人一个人可以娶五个老婆呢？
And I would always ask my mother why women have to cover themselves in Islam.
我也常常问我妈妈，为什么女人就一定要用布把全身都蒙住呢？
And my mom has no answer.
然后我妈妈没有办法回答我这些问题。
And in Islamic religion, God, Allah has 101 names.
而在回教的背景里面，他的天主阿拉他有101个名字。
And one of the name is justice.
其中一个名字就叫公义。
So I would ask my mother, if God is so just, then why is God so unfair to women?
我就问我妈妈，如果这个神是这么的公义，为什么他对女人这么的不公平呢？
So I told, then I had lots of questions. So finally, I decided I'm not going to follow this religion.
我这些问题找不到答案，所以我决定我再也不再信这个宗教了。
So once you don't, and every time actually before that, before I abandoned my religion,
那个时候我还没有放弃我的信仰的时候，
I tried to pray. I used to pray to God, and I always hunger and thirst to know God.
我常常都很热心的去祷告，我非常的渴望认识神。
I try my best to draw close to God.
我很努力的想跟神亲近。
But I would feel nothing. I would feel there is a wall between me and God.
可是我完全感觉不到，我觉得那一位真神在我之间中间有一道墙。
So finally, I decided to leave this religion.
所以我最后放弃了这一个宗教。
And then I got into while I was in school, I got into very bad company.
我在学校的时候遇到一些不是很好的人。
And I became rebellious.
那时候我变得很反叛。
And then I started smoking.
那时候我学会了抽烟。
And then I The moment I abandoned my faith, I also abandoned all the rules and regulations that my religion and my family put on me.
当我决定放弃我的信仰的时候，我也把以前生活上所有的规矩、一切的东西都丢掉了。
I became very rebellious.
我完全成为了一个很反叛的青少年。
I wanted to be free.
我只是想要很自由。
And I wanted to enjoy the freedom of this world.
我想享受这个世上所有的自由。
In the beginning, everything seems very good.
一开始的时候，事情好像蛮不错的。
And I start smoking marijuana.
我开始抽大麻。
And I start drinking.
我也开始喝酒。
And then I met this person, this man.
那最后我认识了一个人。
And then We became friends.
那我们成为朋友。
And then I move in with him to his house. I left home.
我离开了家，跟他住在一起。
My hope was to marry this man.
当时我在想说，以后我就要跟这个人结婚。
But after living with him for a year or so,
但是我跟他一起生活了一年左右。
He didn't want to marry me anymore.
他没有想要跟我结婚。
And the relationship became very dark.
那我们之间的关系变得非常糟糕。
And very painful.
那时候我很痛苦。
And I used to smoke and I used to drink and it felt like I'm wasting my life.
那时候我就把自己沉迷在抽烟喝酒里面，就在那边耗费生命。
And then slowly I realized that I have made a great mistake.
后来我慢慢的发现我这样做是不对的。
I start feeling very guilty.
我开始觉得非常的愧疚。
I felt like I felt ashamed of myself.
我觉得很为自己而觉得很很羞耻。
I felt like not only I disappointed and hurt my mother.
因为我觉得我让我的妈妈非常的失望，非常的难过。
I also disappointed and I hurt God.
因为我觉得我也让神非常的难过跟失望。
I felt extremely guilty.
那时候，因此我觉得非常非常的愧疚。
And I was very miserable.
那时候我很难过。
And because of smoking marijuana, I couldn't concentrate on my studies.
因为我那时候抽大麻的关系，我没有办法去继续我的学业。
So finally, because I realized that this relationship is not going to end into marriage, so I decided to leave him.
那时候，因为我看到这样的跟这个男人这样的关系，并不会进入婚姻，所以我决定了要离开他。
So after I left him, I went into very deep depression.
我离开他以后，进入了一个心情，一个非常的低潮。
I felt like I'm in a very dark place.
我患了忧郁症，我觉得我生活在一个黑暗的空间。
And I felt very heavy burden with sin.
我觉得我在罪的深渊里面。
I felt very unclean and very sad.
我觉得自己很肮脏，我很难过。
And the feelings of guilt was very powerful inside my heart.
那时候，罪恶感占据了我整个心。
My conscience would constantly bother me.
我的良知一直在让我困扰。
I couldn't sleep at night. I felt so restless.
我晚上根本就睡不着觉。
I would constantly cry and cry and cry, and I felt like there's no hope.
我常常的就在那边哭啊哭啊，我觉得生活没有指望。
So I felt very helpless, and I thought that God is not going to accept me again.
那时候我觉得很无助，我也觉得神他不会再要我了。
So this depression and this pain was so deep that I don't want to live anymore.
这样子的忧郁症困扰着我，我根本就不想再活下去了。
I felt the darkness and the sorrow and the guilt was pouring out of my heart like an ocean.
那时候感觉内心里面的痛苦那样子的罪疚感就像河水一样在我的心里面倾泻出来。
I felt no peace in my heart anymore.
我在心里面再也感觉不到平安。
And there is no hope left.
世上没有希望了。
So in order to subside this pain, I used to smoke and to numb myself.
为了去麻痹自己，我就去抽大麻。
And when I smoke, I would sleep all day.
我抽完以后就可以睡一整天。
And I would waste away. I drop out of school. I have no job.
所以这样子我没有办法上学，我就停下了学业，也不能工作。
So the zeal to live completely left me. I was just existing.
那时候，我只是过着一个行尸走肉的生活。
I felt like a great failure, and I wanted to end my life.
那时候我觉得我是一个很没有用的人，我只是想着结束自己的生命。
But then I thought, as a Muslim, we believe if you kill yourself, you're gonna go to hell, and it's even more painful.
然而，在我穆斯林的背景，我的以前的宗教告诉我说，如果你自杀的话，你唯一的出路就是到地狱，然后那是很痛苦的事情。
But then I said, if I live, I would be, it feels like I'm a vegetable. I have no feeling left.
但是如果活着的话，我就好像一个植物一样，我根本就没有感觉。
I was extremely fearful. I didn't have the courage to go out and face people.
我很害怕面对人。
So then I decided I better call for help.
所以那个时候我想说 我希望找人帮助我。
I needed help, someone to help me pull me out of this hell.
我希望有一个人可以把我从这个困境里面拉出来。
So finally I called 911 and I ended up in hospital.
所以那个时候我打电话给911然后进了医院。
And the hospital admitted me to psychiatric ward for acute depression.
那时候我进到医院里面的精神病房。
While I was in hospital, I saw people around me. Many of them are mentally sick.
我那时候在精神病房的时候，我看见旁边的人真的一些精神病的病患。
That is when I thought about my life and I said, well, I committed sin against God and my family, and this is what is my punishment.
那时候我在跟自己讲说，我做了这么多错事，然后今天落在这个境况，这真是，上天对我的惩罚。
That's when I truly experienced hell in my heart.
那个时候我的心里面体验的，地狱的滋味。
And that's the time when I felt the most hopeless when I was in hospital.
在我在医院的时候，是我觉得最绝望的时候。
And there is no light.At the end of the tunnel, it was so dark.
那时候就好像走在一个没有光的隧道里面，全部都是黑暗的。
So in the hospital, I would cry and ask God to help me.
我住院的时候常常在哭，然后呼求神来帮我。
And I would say, God, please have mercy on me and save me.
我向神祷告说，神啊，请帮助我。
And that is when I met a sister from our church in the hospital.
就是在那个医院里，我认识了在我们教会里面的一个姐妹。
And this sister, she started talking to me.
这个姐妹来跟我讲话。
And she asked me why I'm in the hospital.
她问我为什么来到医院里面。
And I shared my story too with her. I felt this immense warmth and closeness with her, so I shared my life to her.
那时候我觉得跟她，跟她讲话很温暖，所以把所有过去的事情都跟她分享了。
And I told her that right now, after they released me from the hospital, I have no job, I have no place to go, I don't know what I'm going to do, I'm completely stranded.
我告诉她说，如果我离开了医院以后，我没有地方可以去，我又没有工作，我真的不知道怎么办好。
And the doctors told me that, the doctors gave me a lot of medication, and the medication is not helping me at all.
那时候医生给我开很多的药，但是这些药对我来讲都没有作用。
And I was admitted in the hospital for a whole month.
我在医院里面住了整整一个月。
So after I shared all my story to the sister was very, he had so much compassion. He was so touched.
我把我所有的故事告诉这个姐妹以后，她很热心，她觉得很受感动。
And she told me that.She will help me. She offered her home to me, and she told me that I can live with her, and all I have to do is cook dinner for her.
她那时候跟我讲说，不用害怕，你可以来住我家，你可以为我煮饭，这样子就够了。
She said she's alone here because her husband is in Taiwan.
因为她说她只是一个人住在家里，她的先生在台湾。
So finally, I decided I will move with the sister.
所以我就住在这个姐妹家里了。
So I moved with her, and I would sleep all day, and I would smoke, and take my medication, and then at night I would wake up and cook dinner for her.
那时候我跟她住在一起，我白天就睡觉，有时候也会抽大麻，然后累了就睡觉，睡醒了在晚上我就煮饭给她吃。
It's the same old things happening in my life.
生活并没有改变。
But I had a little bit glimpse of hope after moving in her house.
然而搬进去以后，好像有一点点的希望。
But that was not enough to pull me out.
然而这样子的一点点的指望没有办法解决我所有的问题。
So, I was still praying and asking God to please help me and save me in my room every night.
每天晚上我仍然向神祷告，求神可以帮助我。
And then, one day, sister shared, her testimony with me.
有一天，这个姐妹来跟我，分享她的见证。
And she told me how God healed her and how God saved her.
她跟我见证神如何的医治她，如何的去拯救她。
And she told me the Lord Jesus Christ is a very forgiving, loving God.
她告诉我说，主耶稣是一个非常充满爱的人，他非常的有怜悯的心。
And one day she invited me to come to church with her because there was a spiritual convocation going on.
因为有一次呢，是有灵恩布道会，他就邀请我来到教会。
So I said yes, and I came to church with her.
那我就答应了，跟着他来到教会里。
So when I came to church, the first day when I entered the church, I felt very peaceful, and I felt as though I've come to my home.
我第一次进到教会的感觉，觉得非常的平安，好像回到家里的感觉一样。
And that feeling is very, very beautiful because there has been many, many years since I had felt no peace.
那个感觉真的非常的美好，因为不知道有多少年我没有感觉到这样子的平安了。
But to feel so peaceful and feel at home was a blessing feeling that God gave me that day.
但是那一天我就感觉到了这份平安，我觉得真的神很祝福我。
And it's amazing, Elder Ho was there at that time too. 10 years have already passed.
那时候是十年前吧，那个时候也是侯长老在这一边。
And he was talking about God's grace and God's love, and I was listening to the message.
他在台上正在讲着神的恩典，神的慈爱。
And the message really touched my heart.
台上的信息深深地打动了我。
And then he announced for everyone to come to the front and to pray to God. And then I just automatically stood up and I went to the front.
他在台上邀请大家来到前面祷告，我奇妙的我就起身来到前面去祷告。
While I was in the front, I kneeled down and I kept crying and crying to God.
我来到台前面跪下来。我就不断地流泪祷告。
And I remember I told God, God, I'm very sorry.
我记得我跟神说，神啊，对不起你。
And I told God, I really failed and I made a great mess.
我跟神忏悔说，我之前真的是做得很不对。
Sorry. And I asked God to help me.
我祈求神帮助我。
And then I remember the elder laid hand on me.
我还记得长老在我头上按手。
And I felt this immense presence of the Lord Jesus.
我感觉到神在我的身边。
And I felt that the Lord poured out His Spirit on me.
我也感觉到神的灵灌在我，浇灌在我的身上。
And I felt that He is really He accepted me and He forgave me.
我感觉到神已经接受了我，原谅了我。
And God's love really touched me.
因为神的爱深深地打动了我。
And the love of the Lord Jesus really cleansed and removed the darkness from my heart.
因为主耶稣的爱，所以让我心中的黑暗可以得到洗涤。
And this His presence gave me this immense hope.And peace.
他在我生命中的出现，给我了美好的平安。
And it was his presence was very cleansing to my heart.
他清洗了我的内心。
It was like you know the currents of ocean. When have you ever been to the beach? Like when the ocean currents they move towards the shore, and it cleanses every debris and every little pieces of stones. They just wash away with the water is so powerful.
我们想想去海边的时候，看到海浪它打到岸上来的时候，就把岸上的一些脏的东西、石头啊什么的都冲走了，岸上就变得很干净。
His presence, His spirit was like that. It just cleanses all the bitterness and darkness from my heart.
神在我生命中的出现就好像这个海浪，把我心目中的苦毒、所有的忧伤全部洗去。
His presence gives me this immense hope.
他给我了无尽的希望。
And His love overpowered and overwhelmed me.
神的爱充满了我。
And I couldn't believe that a sinner like me could receive so much acceptance and forgiveness from God.
我不敢相信像我这样子一个深重的罪人可以从神那边得到这么多。
And my soul was immensely touched and I start praising the Lord with great sense of gratitude.
我整个人的内心充满了感恩，然后不断地向神祈求，感谢神。
And then I was crying, but this time the cry was a cry of joy.
我仍然在流泪，但是这样子的泪水是喜乐的泪水。
And then later the elder told me that I received the Holy Spirit.
然后，长老就告诉我说，我得到了宝贵的圣灵。
And God's love really fulfilled me. His Spirit satisfied my hungering soul.
神的爱真的是让我非常的充满，他让我的生活变得很有意义。
And it felt as though I have finally arrived to my destination, my home.
我觉得我到了我的人生的一个，我回到了家。
It seemed like my soul completely rested in Christ.
我感觉到我的灵魂在主里面得到了美好的安息。
It's almost like somebody who is wandering in a desert for many, many, many years.
就好像一个在沙漠里面流浪了很久的人。
And this person is very hungry and very thirsty and have blisters all over the body because of sun and because of, you know.
这个人他饥饿，他口渴，身上可能因为旅途的关系，身上充满了伤痕。
And finally, this person comes to an oasis.
但是前面他来到了一个绿洲。
And this oasis has got water, got lots of flowers and trees, and it's very beautiful environment. There's water running everywhere, like a beach.
这个美丽的绿洲里面有水、有树木、有花，非常的宜人。
So that's how it felt when my soul met God.
这个就是当我的灵魂遇到神的时候那种美好的感觉。
So I completely rested in Him. I found my destination.
所以我在主里面感觉到非常的平安，我觉得我到了我人生美好的终点。
So I asked the elder, I went to elder and I told the elder, please baptize me.
那时候我马上就跟长老说我要受洗。
And the elder Ho told me that I must read the Word of God.
那侯长老跟我讲说我也要明白神的道理才行。
I must know the Lord and His Word before I get baptized. I just came today in church.
这只是我来到教会的第一天，所以呢，我还是要花一些时间去明白圣经，明白神的话。
But I told the elder, I said, I just want to get baptized right away, and could you please baptize me?
但是我很坚持地跟长老说，我真的很想现在马上就受洗，你可以为我施洗吗？
And then I start crying and crying, and I told elder, "Why God already accepted me? Why you don't baptize me right away?"
那时候我跟长老哭着说，神都已经接受我了，你为什么不跟我施洗呢
？And the elder told me, "You please go home. I will pray to the Lord and see what is His guidance. And if the Lord's will is to baptize you, we will baptize you."
那侯长老就很慈爱地跟我说，你先回去休息吧，我会为你祷告。那如果是神的意愿让你去受洗的话，我们也会为你施洗的。
So I came home that night and I prayed and I cried to the Lord and I said, Lord Jesus, can you please change elder's mind to baptize me?
那我回到家里的时候继续向神祷告，向神祈求说，神啊，祈求你改变侯长老的意思，让他为我施洗吧。
Because I told him in my prayers that right now I feel like I don't belong to the world and I don't belong to you completely. I'm hanging in the middle. I want to completely belong to you.
因为我跟神说，我现在不想再属于这个世界了，但是我又不属于你。我在这个两个事情中间，在没有一个居所。我很希望可以属于你。
So indeed, early in the morning, the elder called me and told me that he prayed to God. It's God's will. We're gonna baptize you.
那第二天早上我接到侯长老的电话，他说我向神祷告，我觉得是神的旨意，我们要为你施洗了。
And I was extremely happy. I was so joyful and so thankful to God.
我那时候非常的高兴，非常的感恩。
So in August of 15, 1999, 3 days after I received the Holy Spirit, I got baptized.
所以在1999年8月15号，就是我得到圣灵三天以后，我的接受了洗礼。
That day was the happiest day of my life.
那是我人生中最开心的一个日子。
I can never forget that day.
我永远都不会忘记那一天。
God completely changed my destiny.
神他完全地改变了我的人生。
When I received the baptism, I felt like a new creation, a new person.
我接受洗礼以后，我觉得我是一个完完全全的新人。
God's great love and His forgiveness and His presence brought amazing healing and transformation in my life.
神的爱多么的奇妙，他改变了我的一切。
I tasted the sweetness of peace that the presence of Jesus Christ bestowed on me.
我感受到了神在我身上给我甜美的爱，甜美的恩典。
This peace is beyond the peace of this material world.
这样子的平安是这个世俗世上的一切不能给我的。
This peace is beyond human understanding.
这样子的平安是我们人所不能够理解的。
It goes to the deepest core of my being.
因为这个是一个非常深的一种感受。
And this peace is the presence of the Christ.
而这样的平安是从神来的。
Lord Jesus Christ is the Prince of Peace.
因为主耶稣他就是平安的王，的君王。
His peace touched the deepest core of my soul and brought immense healing and contentment.
他给我的平安，他让我的心灵得到了很大的安慰。
And then my soul is so satisfied in Him that I feel completely rested.
我的心在这个平安里面觉得非常的舒畅。
The troubles of this world will not touch this peace.
在世上所有其他的劳苦都不会影响这样子的平安。
It's almost like if you're in a storm, and you feel.Yes, there is a storm, but I feel this immense hope that the presence of Christ will carry me. This is beyond this world, this peace.
就好像人在风浪里面，虽然风暴很大，然而有一个平安让我们觉得很安稳。
And the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ also released me from the bondage and the burden of sin.
而主耶稣也让我从罪里面，罪的捆绑里面走了出来。
This is the true freedom that I felt.
这个是我所能见证的真正的自由。
Of course, in the world, people might say, if I don't follow the rules and regulation of this religion or that religion, I can be free.
当然，在世上可能会有人跟我说，你根据这个宗教的这一个规矩、那个规矩的话，你也可以得到自由。
That is not the true freedom.
然而，那不是真正的自由。
A person would truly experience freedom when this person.Finds the presence of Lord Jesus Christ.
一个人只有来到主耶稣的面前，才能够得到真正的自由。
His presence really carries our burdens and releases us of the bondage of sin.
因为主耶稣可以帮我们拿去我们身上的重担，然后得到真正的平安。
All the sense of guilt and shame that I was carrying in my heart left me after I believed in Christ.
之前我心里面所蒙受的羞辱跟愧疚，从此就离开了我。
And day by day, His Spirit really gave me power to overcome my sinful nature.
一天一天的，他给我的圣灵给我的力量，让我胜过了我心目中以前罪恶的部分。
And day by day, His presence gave me the strength and the wisdom to draw close to Him.
一天一天的，圣灵帮助我能够有智慧。接近他。
And day by day, as I decrease in my flesh, the resurrected spirit of Christ increases within me.
一天一天的，我心中的自我变得渺小，然后我神的大能在我的生活当中变得更加重要。
And day by day, as I die to myself, Christ Jesus grows stronger and becomes the king of my heart.
一天一天的，我心目中的自我，开始慢慢的消退。主耶稣在我心中做了王。
And Christ become my reliance.
主耶稣就是我依靠唯一的依靠。
And Christ became my peace.
主耶稣是我的平安。
And Jesus Christ became my freedom, my hope, my joy, and the meaning of my life.
主耶稣是我的，我的自由，我的希望，我的喜乐，我的一切。
And my family truly saw the change in me.
而我的家人也看到了我的改变。
And my mother, in the beginning, she completely gave up on me.
一开始的时候，我妈妈完全放弃了我。
And in the beginning, when I told her, I went back to my family and I told my family that I believe in Jesus. My mother was very disappointed in me.
当我第一天回到家里跟她讲说我现在信耶稣了，那我妈妈非常的失望。
And he told me that she told me she said after all that you've done, finally you give up your family religion too.
他说你在外面做了那么多坏事，现在连家庭的信仰你也放弃了吗？
And I felt that she's very disappointed in me.
我感觉到她对我非常的失望。
And my brother was very disappointed in me also.
我的弟弟也是非常的生气。
But day by day, as they see, my family saw the healing and the change in me, they were amazed.
但是日子渐渐过去，他们看到我的病得到医治，然后我的改变以后，他们开始改变他们的看法。
And my mother was so happy that she told me that Sarah, you're walking in the right path.
我妈妈甚至跟我讲说 ，Sarah， 你现在走的路是正确的。
So when my mother was diagnosed with cancer, she asked the church to come and pray for her.
当我妈妈知道她患了癌症的时候，她甚至邀请教会的信徒来帮她祷告。
So my mom saw the Spirit of Christ and how Jesus really healed me and saved me.
因为我妈妈见证了主耶稣他如何的医治了我的病。
And she glory the name of Christ.
然后她也以主耶稣的名为荣。
And today when I look back to my life,
今天我回头看我的人生。
All the failures, all the suffering, all the burden of sin, all the misery. When I think of those things, I thank God.
我回头看我曾经受过的苦，还有一切不幸的事情，我所犯的罪，我还是有一个感恩的心。
I thank God because of all that suffering. Today, I'm able to taste the grace and the peace of Christ.
我感谢神，因为就是经过那样子的苦难，所以我今天可以在神这里体会到他甜美的爱。
I thank God for every mistakes and every failure that today I have the presence of Christ with me.
今天我有神与我同在，所以我觉得，之前所承受的一切都不算什么。
And although this lifeseems quite meaningless, but Christ Jesus brought immense meaning to my life.
虽然我的生命本来是微不足道的，但是神仍然拣选我。
Because He gave us the hope of glory of eternal life.
他给我们带来了永生的盼望。
Because He promised us eternal life.
他也给我们一个应许，就是永生。
His death and His resurrection brought so much.Blessing to all creation. The death and resurrection of Christ brought blessing to humanity.
因为他为我们在十字架上受死，然后带给我们的就是这个永生的盼望。
So our hope is not in this world. Our hope is in Christ. That if we continue to follow Him, one day by His grace, we will have eternal life.
所以我们继续的走在这条路上，持守这个信仰。最后我们就会，在主里面得到永生。
And I'm so thankful to God that the Lord Jesus saved my sister also.
我也非常的感谢神，他救了我的姐妹。
The Lord's grace is so abundant upon me and my family that I have no words to thank Him.
神非常的祝福我和我的家人，所以这份感激的 心情我没有办法用言语来表达。
I'm so honored that He chose me and He saved me and He healed me.
我很感恩神他拣选我，他救赎我。
I'm so honored that I have His presence.
我很感恩他与我同在。
I just want to share a Bible verse with you before I end my testimony.
我用一个圣经的经节跟大家分享来结束我的见证。
John chapter 14 verse 27.
是约翰福音十四章二十七节。
John chapter 14.
约翰福音十四章二十七节。
Verse 27.Okay, and peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid.
我留下平安给你们，我将我的平安赐给你们。我所赐的不像世人所赐的，你们心里不要忧愁，也不要胆怯。
Lord Jesus Christ truly gave us peace.
主耶稣给我们真平安。
And this peace is beyond this world.
这个平安是世人不能给我们的。
And His presence is this peace.
而主的同在就带给我们这个平安。
So when we make the Lord our reliance,
只要我们信靠神。
And when we make Him the King of our hearts,
让他在我们心中作王。
He becomes our peace, our joy, our hope.
他就是我们的平安，我们的希望，我们的源泉。
I also want to share John chapter 16 verse 33.
我也想跟大家分享约翰福音十六章。
John chapter 16 verse 33.
十六章三十三节。
I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world.
三十三节，我将这些事告诉你们，是要叫你们在我里面有平安。在世上你们有苦难，但你们可以放心，我已经胜了世界。
No matter how much the storms of life would attack us,
不管人生的风浪如何的攻击我们
，But in Christ we will have peace.
然而在主里面，我们就有真平安。
That is what I have experienced.
这就是我人生的感受。
May all glory and honor and praise be unto the name of Lord Jesus Christ.
愿一切的荣耀颂赞归给天上的真神。
Thank God.
感谢神。